Hey guys, welcome back to Let's Play Stalker Clear Sky.
Hey buddy, put your shooter away and come over here. We need to have a chat.
A chat, huh? Yeah, sure, we can do that. Well, that was a good talk. Really great guys, those bandits. And really, if you walk up to them when they tell you that they need to talk to you, they'll just rob you and take all your money, and even if you kill them all, you can't get it back.
Listen, dumbass. This here's our area and our camp, so why don't you find yourself a road that don't lead to a grave?
Fine, jeez. What's a jerk around these parts? Show you guys how I deal with jerks. Give me a second. No, don't move. I'll fix it. There we go. Now this marks the very first really hard fight in the game if you use the complete lock. So I have to play it much more carefully than I normally do, so it's very long, very boring, so I'm going to speed this up a little bit. As you can see, even with the upgrades for accuracy, the AK-74 is still fairly inaccurate at range. You can see some of the rounds spraying off way to the side over there. Very good thing that I've been stocking up on first aid kits and bandages, because you do need it. The difficulty does spike up. A few people were worried about the fact that Clear Sky Complete mod might make it too easy, but really it's not the case.
Man, I was sure as hell I'd die here like a dog. I don't even know how to thank you. Wait, I do know how to thank you. I'm going to upload the coordinates of a place me and the boys used to stash our loot before we were captured and sent here. My buddies won't need it no more where they are now. May they rest in peace. And I'm getting the hell out of the zone right this moment. I figure anywhere's better than this place.
You know, you're kind of calm for having just been set on fire. Especially by a random pillar of flame that just jet out of the ground. So we got information for a stash for helping them out, and I really hold no loyalties towards them, so I'm gonna run out of here before the next group of bandits comes looking for their friends. Yeah, good luck with that, guys. The garbage. We all remember this area from the first game. This game, you can explore it a little bit more because there's not as much radiation or anomalies going around in the area. And you actually do have to explore it a little bit in order to get to some areas for this quest that we're on right now. So the stalkers we had to look for information about Fang are all dead.
I gave Fang the component we found in the cache. He wouldn't stop swearing and said he wouldn't pay us until we found the other components. We discussed it between ourselves and decided to send Vasya to speak to him. Vasya is one silver-tongued son of a gun. We figured he might be able to talk Fang into paying us at least some of the money. I just hope he doesn't run into trouble on the way there.
So the stash that we want to go to is right next to a huge base of bandits, but fortunately, they're all on the inside. We can walk around the huge facility without having to worry about any bandits. And it's actually not that difficult to get to. So anyway, you might remember Fang from the first Stalker game, where we actually had to walk through a tunnel with the Psi Mission helmet to turn off the Brain Scorcher, and we found Fang's dead body in the very end of it. The only question now, though, is will we find Fang before he dies or not? This takes place shortly before Shadow of Chernobyl, so he may not be dead. Packs of pseudo-dogs are still not all that threatening, considering they will usually scatter if you kill one or two of them. So it looks like a clear path to the stash. However, there's a very heavy psi field in the area. Can you hurry up, grab the item, and run out? This is psi damage. You don't really see it too often in this game, except for during a psi emission, but we'll get to that later. Basically, it hurt us pretty bad and very fast. Try to avoid it whenever you can. And the after effects of all the blurry double vision is sometimes worse than the damage itself. So what was in that stash that was so important? The item that we got out of the stash is an upgraded 1911. You might remember me using the 1911 in the previous game in my Let's Play, because it's got good power and decent accuracy for a handgun. And this one has been upgraded for, I believe, increased accuracy, reduced weight, and increased magazine capacity. Not only has it been upgraded, but the 1911's base stats were also upgraded between Shadow of Chernobyl and Clear Sky, so now it's more accurate than it was before. It's the second most accurate pistol in the game, and the second most damaging pistol in the game. It's also the second slowest firing, but when you have accuracy and power, you don't really need to worry about how fast you can shoot it. Hearing up on the area where we're supposed to meet the man who talked to Fang, well, it doesn't sound like he's having much of a easy time around
here. Hey,
buddy,
watch out! There's a shitload of dogs around here! Climb onto the rocks, quick!
Shitload of dogs, huh? Yeah. So about those dogs.
Shoot them!
There we are.
Hey now.
We probably should be the best area to have the shotgun at. You'll be very thankful if you have one, because hitting these guys.
The only loot they got out of this camp is a few bullets in their heads!
Thanks, buddy. You saved me right there. My name is Vasyan. Picture this. I'm on my way west, trying to catch up with this stalker, minding my own business and all, and these eyeless beasts come out of nowhere. I emptied 3 clips into the damn things, but they just kept on coming and chased me all the way to here. There's no way I'll catch that stalker now. He's got to be in the Dark Valley at this point. I'm listening.
And that is one area where the dogs won't scatter, no matter how many you kill. Despite them being not all that threatening in terms of health, they do have a high amount of numbers, and one hit on you will hurt quite a bit. Especially if you look at our armor, it's the little blue line above the red line for our health. You might not see it because it's almost non-existent. Our armor is just about broken. Fortunately, as we saw earlier in the game, there are the upgrade guys that will repair your armor, but it does cost quite a bit. Fortunately, I think we might just have enough. All we have to do is find somebody who can repair it, and that'll come up really soon. Until then, we're gonna have to be really careful in fights.
Quarantine, put your weapon away, and come here very slowly.
Freeze! Holster your weapon and stand still. Try pulling a fast one and you're dead. Stand still, brother. This won't hurt.
If you value your freedom, I want
All right, stalker. Stay put. Who are you, and what are you doing here? He's probably dead already, and I suggest you don't hang around here too long, unless you want to join him. Someone keeps attacking us. They're real professional about it, too. We never stand a chance. We control all the roads leading into the Dark Valley, but that don't seem to stop the attacks one bit. The one place you can relax is the base. If you have questions about Fang, the Freedom Base is your best bet.
I ain't too good of hearing. Speak louder.
Sorry that I had to cut that little dialogue short. If I keep Fraps running at the time that it goes into a loading screen, then the game will crash. We'll be seeing a lot more game crash instances later. Oh boy, will we be seeing them. We'll get to that when we come to it. Yes. That is, Freedom. We didn't see them too early on in the last,
Stalker game. Hey, what's happening over there? Answer me!
They aren't exactly my favorite faction. Kinda see why in a little bit. Weapons so that I can sell them off. And you've been seeing some new pistols in the inventories of enemies. One is the Browning High Power that we found on some bandits, and the one that we just picked up is the Beretta M92. They aren't as good as the pistol we've got right now, so I just grabbed them to sell them.
So, what did you Stalker, want to tell me?
You are on Freedom territory, and that means no funny business. Come see me if you have any questions.
This is the Freedom Base.
What's your business here?
Real nice place you got here.
What's this? Your backyard? Who let you in?
The best stalker clan the Zone has to offer. Where else would you be accepted for who you are? Don't lose your freedom. Join us.
And quit bothering me over nothing. I'm busy.
Before we go out and get that pseudo dog, you get some of our gear repaired.
Give me five, bro. What's it gonna be? Oh, a hard drink or a soft smoke? Come by next week. We're expecting some real high-class herb.
It'll
get you higher than
$20.
Really? And this is why I do not like Freedom. They really seem out of place in this zone.
You get it, okay? Move your ass!
They
give it a real jerk, you know?
It's not exactly my, It doesn't convince me that they can actually compete against the military and against duty. That wasn't actually the guy that can repair my armor. We'll see him a little bit later. Yes, everything always happens later. There's the pseudo dog. You notice us, so might as well blow it up.
Boy, you showed those mutants. Come back for more instructions.
Now, pseudo dogs didn't do that in the last Stalker game. It'll actually make mirror images of itself. And that can be very confusing if one comes up behind you, but not really that much, not much of a threat if you fight it head on like that.
What's this? How's it shaping up, Merc?
Too many bombs around here.
Alrighty, show me your harvest. Hey, buddy, what will you be needing today? Bam, bam!
Here is your chance to join the best stalker clan the Zone has to offer. Where else would you be accepted for who you are? Don't lose your freedom. Join us!
Outpost was attacked. I don't know if anyone survived, but the PDA is still active. It might contain some useful info. Find it and bring it to me.
And yes, that guy's name was Chekhov. Not what it sounded like he said. I feel like NATO weapons in... This is a good area to get early access to the,
Shit, man. L85. Only to screw up. What a rotten son of a bitch, that commandant! All that horseshit he gave us about how the outpost was out of ammo! Those freedom bastards wounded two of our boys!
Enough yapping! Let's cover up our tracks and get out of here!
So far, its stats are worse than the AK-74 that we have. Or AK-47. Either one. The stats are worse, so I'm just picking them up to sell them off, since the store is really close by. It's a good way to get some extra money, and you will need it if you need it.
If you want to be appreciated and treated like family, that's freedom all the way. There's no chores, no brainwashing, and no morning wake-up drills. If you're a real stalker who loves the free life and a good drink in the company of like-minded fellas,
welcome to my humble abode. Well, well, finally we meet face to face. My name is Chekhov, and I'm the boss around here. The recording on the PDA you found clears things up a bit. All the exits from the valley were sealed off, but our outposts and patrols just kept getting hit. A few times we had a patrol leave the base and get slaughtered in no time. The boys started thinking that we offended the Zone somehow, and that this was some sort of punishment. We even tried putting together protection charms against ghosts and all, but as we now know, there was nothing mystical about it. The Commandant gave away all our movements. Freaking rat. I didn't expect him to do this. I've known him for ages. We hunted for our first artifacts together. We made freedom what it is today.
Made freedom what it is today, huh?
Give me five, bro. What's it gonna be? A hard drink or a soft smoke?
Is it me, or are everyone's hands growing out of their asses?
I wonder why he left.
I trusted him with all the operational planning, and he just went and sold us out. As soon as the outpost conversation was aired on our radio frequency, the Commandant vanished. He knew he was screwed. What we've got to do now is find him. He knows too much, if not everything. All the exits from the valley are secured, so he couldn't have gone too far. We're tracking his PDA. He's near the road to the cordon. A few of our squads are on their way over there. Yep, there was a stalker like that. Very interested in rare parts and the like. He must have known that we had the best team in the whole Zone. I sold him the part he wanted, and why not? He paid well and didn't even haggle. What I don't know is what he wanted with it. These parts were only used in old army cryptographic machines. He left the base straight away, and nobody's seen him since. Yeah, I'll help you. If you help me, that is. Don't take it personally, but we're having a rough time. And if things don't change, Freedom won't have enough men to defend the base from bandit attacks. Help me find out who is attacking us, and I'll give you information about Fang. Find the Commandant and bring him to me, alive. Or dead. Do that, and I'll tell you where you can find Fang. I've uploaded the coordinates of the Commandant's PDA to yours. Good luck. Keep me abreast of any new information.
So, despite Freedom saying that they have the best team around, I can't help but notice that, they're using a mercenary to do quite a bit of their own work for them.
What did you break? Is it me, or are everyone's hands growing out of their asses? Nah, it's not me.
So I'm just gonna repair our armor, which basically cost all the money that we had. Thankfully, I did take those L85s, and we can go sell them off right now.
Wait a sec! Hey, buddy! Mercantilism, schmercantilism!
Now we're a little better off now.
Hey,
we won't take nearly as much damage from bullets now.
If you're looking to be appreciated and treated like family, that's freedom all the way. There's no chores, no brainwashing, and no morning wake-up thrills. If you're a real stalker who loves the free life and a good drink in the company of like-minded fellas, join right in. We've always got old boards for new...
Now you're getting a good look at Stalker Clear Sky at night. It is very, very dark at night. You can't see a whole lot, and this mod actually increases the brightness and range of your flashlight. Normally, in the original Clear Sky game, your flashlight is pretty much useless. You won't be able to see anything, and enemies have pinpoint accuracy even in the darkness. So that's another issue that the original game had.
Attention all Freedom Squads! We just ran into mercenaries by the old farm. We're meeting strong resistance. We need help. I repeat, we need reinforcements immediately.
Now, Dark Knights in themselves isn't that bad, because they didn't change the darkness in this complete mod. But they did give you better visibility, which is crucial to actually play the game. Can't really do a whole lot if I can't see any enemies, but their vision isn't hampered at all.
Probably the best area in the game to find weapons with silencers on them. Mercenaries tend to have them, and this is the most concentrated area of mercenaries. So now we got a silencer on our AK-74. So if you fight these mercenaries, you won't be hated by them, and you won't get kicked out of your group.
I prefer to hold a conversation without...
Though it doesn't really give you any perks to be in the mercenary faction to begin with, though. In this stash, we found some rifle grenades. We can't use them without a grenade launcher for the rifles, but they are pretty rare to find. Some stalkers will have them, but you have to really know where to look.
I ain't too good.
You might be able to get a stash that has one. You're better off trying to buy one but if you miss your chance, it can take a while for the grenade launcher to pop back up in the store owner's inventory.
So, what did you want to tell me?
Welcome to my house. Thanks for your help. After the shootout at the farmhouse, we know that mercenaries are behind the attacks on Freedom. Information from the Commandant's PDA also confirms this. The question is, why the hell are they doing it? Mercenaries have always stayed neutral and cooperated with all of the Zone's factions. I wonder who the client was for this little job. Perhaps it was duty, or the army. I've got more questions than answers right now, but I'll get to the bottom of this. You can bet on it. You've held up your end of the deal, and now I'll tell you about Fang. He was looking for rare components here, and I got real curious as to what he wanted with all that ancient crap. When I asked him directly, he told me to mind my own business. It's too bad I'm not a quitting type. I asked one of our tech guys to hack into his PDA's frequency, and we were able to monitor him for a few days. It looks like he went to the garbage. I'd look for him there. By the way, I made a note of his PDA frequency, and I've already uploaded it for you. His location is now marked on your PDA. Are you ready to help Freedom once again?
Yeah, right.
Alright, enough talking. Let's get to work.
This is really the last we'll see of the Freedom base. I am pretty much done here. So thanks a lot for watching, everybody. I will see you in the next part of Let's Play Stalker Clear Sky.